For a Fresnel diffraction case, calculate the position of two brightest points on the axis if a circular aperture of 1 mm diameter is incident with a plane wave of wavelength 500 nanometer. So let us first write all that is given to us. We are given aperture diameter as 1 millimeter, which makes radius as 0.5 into 10 raised to minus 3 meters. Second quantity is wavelength 500 nanometer, and we are asked to calculate two positions which we are representing by B. If you recall from previous lectures, we know that radius is given by root of NB lambda, where N is number of zones and B is distance from the axis, distance from the screen. We know the intensity variation with respect to N goes like, if I have N on x axis and intensity on y axis, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and so on, then it will roughly go like maximum at 1, minimum at 2, then again increasing, then again decreasing. It will go something like this, where the maximum intensity will come for n equals 1 and the second maximum intensity will come for n equals 3. So for every odd number, as the n keeps on increasing, our maximum intensity will keep on decreasing and the pattern will start to get more and more crowded. And the first darkest point will come when we have only two zones, and even the darkest point's darkness will keep on reducing as n keeps on increasing. So now we know that we are asked to calculate B1 and B3. So let us rewrite it as, we are asked B1 and B3. Since we are calculating B equals R square by N lambda. Let us solve it quickly. B1 equals R square by 1 into lambda equals, our R is 0.5 into 10 raised to minus 3 whole square divided by lambda being 500 into 10 raised to minus 9. Solve this, we will get 25 into 10 raised to minus 8 divided by 5 into 10 raised to minus 7, and this would give us 0.5 meters B1. So this is one answer. Let us solve for B3. B3 would be R square by 3 into lambda. So what we can do simply is this 0.5 divided by 3. It would be 0.16 meter. So you can see that closest the distance, largest is the number of n. Here, if R is kept constant, if B is going higher, in the same way n will go down. So these are compensating each other's effect. In order to get maximum number of B, in order to get maximum number of zones, B should be minimum, and as we start to increase B, that is distance of the screen, N would start to reduce. If we make B as infinity, N would go less than 1 and we will go from Fresnel's to Fraunhofer class. So that's it for today. Thank you.